Hey guys, welcome to the cat way. In this video, we are going to solve a LRD set based on reasoning and pie chart. Before we begin, I would like to thank all the people joining us, and our Facebook group link is there in the description below. Now let's roll in for today's video. Let's check out the question. The question says that Hari wrote 6 exams, each in a different subject among maths, physics, chemistry, economics, botany, and zoology. The pie chart below, which is drawn to scale, provide the marks scored by Hari in each subject as a percentage of total marks obtained by him in all the 6 subjects put together. The names of the subjects have intentionally been left out in the pie chart, and instead the subjects are labeled as S1 to S6 in no particular order. Further, it is also known that, so in the pie chart, S1, S2, S3 sustained an angle of 90, 45 and 45 degree. Hari scored 15 marks less in chemistry than in economics, so we can say that marks in economics is greater than that in chemistry. And he scored more in chemistry than compared to physics. So it is also greater than physics. The angle subtended that S4 subtended at the center is smaller than that subtended by S3. So we can say that S4 is the smallest, because we can see that S4 is smaller than S5, S1 and S6. And it is saying that S4 is less than S3, and S3 and S2 are equal. So we can say that S4 is the smallest. Now, fourth point, the marks scored by Hari in maths are same as the sum of the marks scored by him in 2 other subjects, in each of which Hari scored an equal number of marks. Now connect this point to the first point. Okay, so it says that the marks in maths is equal to sum of 2 other subjects in which both are equal. Whereas the first one says that S1 is 90, S2 is 45 and 45. That is, S1 is the sum of S2 and S3, where S2 and S3 both are equal. Okay, so what do we have here? We can say that maths is S1, but we cannot say definitely anything about S2 and S3 as of now. Now come to the fifth point, the difference between the highest marks that Hari scored in any subject and the lowest marks that Hari scored in any subject is 55. Hari scored 30 marks less in zoology than in chemistry. So chemistry is greater than zoology too. Okay, now what we have here, we can surely say that chemistry is greater than at least 2 and economics is greater than at least 3. Now economics can only come at S6 or S5. And chemistry can come at, let's see, can chemistry come at S4? It is not possible, because it is the smallest one. Chemistry, let's take it to S2 or S3. If it comes to either of them, it will only be greater than S4, which is again not a possible case. So chemistry can only come at S5, because S6 is greater than S5. Okay, so let's take chemistry to S5. Okay, and let's take economics to S6. Now what we can do is, let's move ahead now. Let's see what else can we do. So we can zoology we have 3 options. Basically there are 2 options. It can be either S2 or S3, or it can be S4. Okay, so in the first case, let zoology be represented by S3. Okay, so S2 or S3. Let's give zoology to S2 or S3. Now if Hari scored 2x in maths, okay, so maths is 2x, so we can say that in zoology he scored x, and in some other subject also he scored x. Okay, and in S4, what is his score? His score is maths minus 55. This we can say from 0.5, that highest and lowest difference is 55. So highest is maths, that is 2x, and S4 is the lowest. So S4 will be 2x minus 55. Okay. Now we can also say that Hari score in economics be y. Okay. So chemistry would be y minus 15. It is given that economics is 15 marks more than chemistry. And also we can say that in zoology it will be y minus 45, because it is 30 less than chemistry. Okay, so in zoology it would be y minus 45. Okay, now we can say, we can combine these two. X is equal to, we can write it as x is equal to y minus 45. We can say y minus x is equal to 45. So we have our first equation. Okay. Now Hari score in the subject represented by S4 will be 2y minus 145, because we can put x is equal to y minus 45 in here. What do we get? We get 2y minus 145. Okay, so 2y minus 145, since x is equal to y minus 45. Now what we can say is that the sum of scores of Hari in the subject represented by S4, S5 and S6 would be 4x. Why we can say that? See, we know that maths is 2x. Okay, so if maths is 2x, that means this half in which maths is there, S2 and S3 are there, will be 4x. So the other half where economics is there, chemistry is there and S4 is there, would be 4x. Okay, so what we can say is, we know that economics is y, we know that chemistry is y minus 15, and we know that S4 is 2y minus 145 and this all is equal to 4x. Okay, so these all is equal to 4x. From this, what will we get? 4x minus 4y is equal to 160. Okay, or what we can say is, sorry, this is 4x. This will be 4y and this will be 4x is equal to 160, or what we can say is y minus x is equal to 40. So these two are contradictory, so we can definitely say that zoology won't come into S2 and S3. So that means zoology would go into S4. So now we have all our subjects defined. Zoology will be S4 and physics and botany can come into S2 and S3 in any order because they both are equal. Now again we have to find the marks. Okay, so now what we can say is that in this case, now taking this case, when zoology is S4, okay, when zoology is S4, zoology will be y minus 45. Okay, again we are taking all the conditions same as before. Economics is y, chemistry is y minus 45. We can say that zoology will be y minus 45. Okay, so zoology is y minus 45. In maths, as we can say that he scored 2x, so which must be same as y plus 10. Okay, y plus 10. I hope you are getting it, why it is y plus 10, because maths minus S4 is equal to 55. So zoology is S4 now, so maths minus y plus 45 is equal to 55, or we can say maths is equal to 55 minus 45, that is 10 plus y, so we can say it as y plus 10. I hope it's clear. So maths, what we have is y plus 10. Okay, so now what we can say is that 2x, because earlier we took maths as 2x, it will be equal to y plus 10. Now what do we have is 2x minus y is equal to 10. Okay guys, so 2x minus y is equal to 10. Now again, going by the previous one only, that marks of Hari in economics, chemistry and zoology, that is S5, S6 and S4 is 4x. So we can say that y minus 15 and y minus 45. Okay, some of these will be equal to 4x. Okay, so some of these will be equal to 4x. So we can say that 3y minus 60 is equal to 4x. What we can say is 3y minus 4x is equal to 60. Okay, so we have this. Now on solving these two equations, equation 1, this is equation 1 and this is equation 2, what do we get is, we get y is equal to 80 and x is equal to 45. Okay, now we have all our values, so we can calculate all the subjects marks with the help of these. Okay, so because maths is 2x, so maths will be 90, physics and botany are x and x, so they will be this is 90, so x is equal to x is 45, so these two will be 45 45 each. Similarly, we can calculate for these also, because we know all of them in terms of y. Okay, now let's move ahead to solve our questions. Let's check out what questions do we have. What is the total marks scored by Hari across the six subjects? We know maths is 2x, so 4 in it is 90 degree, that is 1/4, so 4 into 4 we'll do what do we get? We get 2x into 4 is equal to 8x. X value we know as 45, so our total will be 360. Okay, so that is our answer. Correct answer, option B. Now the second question, in the given pie chart, the sector representing which of the following subjects is definitely adjacent to the sector representing zoology. So we know that zoology is being represented by S4. Okay, so either it has to be adjacent one is physics or it is chemistry. Let's see which one of these is there in our options: economics, math, chemistry and physics. So we have chemistry, so it will be our answer, option. Now let's come to the third question. What is the angle subtended by pie chart in the pie chart by the sector which represents the marks scored by Hari in chemistry? So we know that the total marks is 360 and Hari's marks in chemistry is y minus 15, that is equal to 18 minus 15, that is 65 marks. So 65 marks out of 360 will be equal to 65 degrees, because the total here is 65, the total in pie chart is 360, total here is 360, 65 of that would give me 65 degrees. So that will be option C. So with this, this set is solved. I hope it's clear how to go ahead with these type of sets. Thanks for watching the video, guys.